Sorry, I don't know. Okay, no, I'm not even sorry. I look horrible anymore because I believe in proactive humiliation. So the worst I look today is good because that means that tomorrow I'll look better than the worst day. So anyway, this is what I got. The manager at the apartment, or the maintenance guy at the apartment complex, he was cleaning out an old apartment, and he gave me this washer and this dryer. But I wanted to make a video showing how I use them because, I mean, they are smaller size, which is helpful. However, I still have to go up all the way in my wheelchair. My wheelchair has an elevator, which is breaking because this wheelchair is over, I don't know, probably like 7 years old by now. It's way over 6 years old. But Medicare, I'm on Medicare and Medicaid, and so I have to wait till they get in. Okay, so now this is how I do my laundry, and you're gonna, oh man, see, you're not even gonna be able to see a lot of it. Well, maybe if I move, kind of, yeah, you can kind of see some stuff. Anyway, okay, so I have to move the wheelchair up as high as I can get it, and then I turn it off so that I don't accidentally bump the controller when I'm trying to reach in there and get the clothes. Oh yeah, I suppose I needed to. Okay, now I have to turn it on. Turn it on. Back up. Open the driver's door. Turn this off again. Okay, and now, well, I'm gonna, no, see, now I'm in a bad position for the camera. Alright, so I'm gonna angle my chair slightly differently just so you can kind of see what I'm doing. But you're still gonna be blocked out from a lot of it. But sorry, that's just the way it has to be because this laundry area is wonderful and convenient and stuff, but it's, you know, I am a rather wide boat, so, I lost a lot of the camera, but, okay, so now that I'm up as high as the wheelchair can possibly go, I can almost reach the entire end, like the whole bottom of the washer, since it's not very big, it's not very deep. So that's nice. Sometimes though I have to kind of, you know, lean out of the wheelchair so I can actually reach all that stuff. And I try to use the bigger items of clothing to kind of catch the little ones, and I'll do that with the dryer as well. Like, you use the big piece of clothing and like catch the little one with it and then pull it over and it works. So I do that a lot, and then let's see. Oh, I've almost got it totally empty. I left my clothes in here a little bit long, but I don't think they smell. It's not super strong. Can you smell them? If you can smell them over the internet, then we have a problem. But no, I'm pretty sure they're okay. It is just like open. Okay. Come on. There's just, oh yeah. Okay, that worked. There's this one string that came off of one of my pants that kind of caught underneath the rotator of the washing machine. But I'm not worried about that. Okay, so now, coming out of here, and then I have to go all the way down, and then that way I can get into the dryer and reach the dryer. But now the dryer is nice too, but the lint trap is actually on the very back of the dryer wall. It's really weird. I'll show you. Kind of hard to get to, since it is that good. I already had emptied it. But this is the lint trap. Isn't that weird? And so it sticks on the back of the wall of the dryer. It just like fits into a little thing. But anyway. Okay. But then I also need to put some laundry in the booth, like the apartment complexes machines, because my seat cushions, I washed them a while ago and they are still not drying. They still feel heavier than what they should feel, and that's how I can tell if they're wet, because the outside feels pretty dry, but I don't know, my hands feel everything weird anyway, because, pretty much dry clothes will feel damp unless they're warm. So I can never tell if things are, dry or wet or whatever. I mean, sometimes I can tell, but it's not all the time. Okay, so now I guess I'm going to throw these ones in a little load in the washer. Just, I don't have very much stuff to wash right now, but I might as well since I'm already kind of doing laundry. So I like these little packets of soap because it's much easier for me than to pour the entire, a big liquid jug. Or a box. Those things are so heavy, and so these little fling things, they actually really are an aid to those of us who are disabled. So kudos to you, inventor of the laundry fling, because that was a good idea, and now it helps all of us. Cripple. And sorry if that term offends you. It doesn't offend me because, I don't know, look it up. It's not like a bad term. It's just people decided that it was going to be derogatory, and so now it is. But I don't know. I don't mind it. My legs are not, they don't work as they're supposed to, so by the technical definition of cripple, I believe I fit it. I think I fit it even more when I was walking, but falling all the time. And, my walk was so uneven and stuff. My balance was so horrible. I think then I was even more of a cripple than I am now. Because my chair, my wheelchair, gives me freedom. And especially having the ability to raise the seat up to lift it where I can get into the washer, that's really beneficial. And then it can lower back down so I can get into the dryer. Because if my chair was constantly up high, it would make my life so much more difficult. But I do occasionally need to get up. This is supposed to bring you up basically to standing height, which it's like a short person standing height, but it works. And anyway, so the seat elevator apparently is not going to be covered by Medicare anymore and Medicaid or whatever, but so that's kind of a bummer. But I'm going to fundraise or something to get it. I'm asking that it be put on my wheelchair anyway because it's the seat function that I use most regularly. Okay, I think I got the laundry done, so that's it for now. Bye.